Now we're finally ready to move to part C on the backside, to actually calculate the vector force for this particular case where things are off at an angle. Remember, we've already calculated the magnitude of the force, and we have our diagram. Because our diagram shows that the forces are off at angles, we have to use trigonometry to calculate those components of the force. I'm going to start with the first charge. Now, writing this out in terms of equations, remember that the x component of the force is going to be the magnitude of the force times the cosine of the angle measured with respect to the x-axis. And the y component is going to be the magnitude of the force times the sine of the angle. And again, these angles are the typical polar coordinate angles, which means they're measured with respect to the x-axis, which is the same angle that we've had measured here in our problem. So our 110 degrees is what we're going to use. So when we go to plug everything in, then what we see is that we use the magnitude of the force and the cosine of the angle to give us the x component of the force, and we get the y component of the force using the sine of the angle. So we've got an x component and a y component of the force.